Hello everyone, Pedro here with GetResponse, and in this video I'll be showing you how you can add a link to your site menu. Make sure that you have a website, and if you don't, you can check our previous tutorials on how you can create one. And without further ado, let's get started. We need to access Manage Pages on the right. We click here, and then the little icon at the bottom, right next to Other Page. Let's click on it as well. In here you'll see all the options for adding a link. I will be explaining to you all of them one by one with examples. And the first one is here. So the link text is what will appear in the site menu. Everyone will see it. And then the URL is where people will be redirected to. This will be totally your choice. I chose GetResponse's website as an example. If you are an affiliate, you might want to redirect people to your affiliate link. And here you would choose how you should open the link. It can be on a new tab or can be on the same one. If you don't want people to exit your website, you would keep in a new tab. And it's pretty self-explanatory, and I will show you how it will behave. And as you can see, in my example, the GetResponse website opened. Let's check the other ones. And the next one we have is landing page. So the only difference from this one and the previous one is that you select a landing page from here. As I only have one, we only see one. Make sure that you have at least one landing page, otherwise you will not see anything here. And you just select one here, and people would then be redirected to it, exactly as the previous one. The next option is email address. This one is a little bit different. You will add your email address here, the email address that you want to be contacted on by other people, by your visitors. And here is how it works. My screen will split as I'm on a full screen, but what's important here is that the app that people use to send emails will open, and your email address will appear on the to field. People can then write you an email. It's very useful. Let's now go back to the next option. And the next one is regarding the phone number. What you need to consider here is that you need to include the country code. So you include country code and your phone number in front of it. This will allow people to call you. And the behavior is as in here. In my case, it asks for FaceTime, as it would be my app to perform a call, but depends on who is trying to access it, and they can choose any other app. Depends on the user, of course. Next one, we have custom protocol. This is a little bit more advanced. If you are not so familiar, I don't recommend using it right away. This will execute a protocol. In my case, I chose mail to. This means that the inbox will open just as the email address behavior that we saw previously. And I can add a subject line and a body, for example. So if you want a pre-made message, you could use this option. I will show you how it will work. It's very similar to the other one. In this example, there are many custom protocols that you can use. And as you can see, subject and the body was pre-filled. Let's now head to the next example. And the next one is regarding a document. A document will open and people can save it. This document can come from files and images, you can browse there, or can come from your computer, you just attach the document, and then it will open when people click on the page. Here's how it is. Document opens, people can then save it, totally up to them. Let's head back to our examples. And the next one is to access a different website. So this is a website from your account. If you have any other website, you'll be able to choose here. I have a language school website I can choose. And it's pretty interesting because you can also choose the page within this website. So I could send people to my offer page, opening a new tab, and then when they click, they will be redirected there, just as the first example we saw. And last but not least, we have current website, which means that people would be redirected to a page from this current website. And if you have multiple pages that would refer to one, in the example here, we have an About Us page, and I created another with Our Story. If people click on Our Story, they will be redirected to About Us. And that's it. I hope you guys now create a website and use the site links to your advantage. And I will see you in the next video. Have a nice day.